Philippine Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III calls out the Employees Compensation Commission, which is mandated to compensate workers in the public and private sectors in case of work-related illness, injury, or death. The agency pegged the cash assistance to workers who contracted COVID-19 at work at only 10,000 pesos. He says this is not enough. Secretary Bello joins us this morning to talk about this and other issues. Good morning, Mr. Secretary, and thanks for joining us.
Good morning, Wayne. Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays, sir. How did the ECC come up with this amount of only 10,000 to compensate workers with COVID-19?
Yes, that is true, Wayne. In fact, I have been asking our director to consider reviewing the compensation rate for our workers, especially if they are contaminated with COVID-19. But aside from the cash assistance of 10,000, our workers will be assisted in their hospitalization.
Mm. Up to how much, sir? And as of now, how many workers are qualified to claim this 10,000 peso aid?
All workers, regardless of their status, from contractual to casual to regular, all these are entitled to compensation if they are work-related.
Hmm. Now, how much do you recommend if you don't think that 10,000 pesos is enough? And if you recommend a particular amount, would there be enough funds for it? Where would it come from?
That's right. That's the reason why I asked our executive director, Stella, Tanawis, to consider upgrading the assistance, because ECC has about 90 billion plus funds. So I told her that if a worker gets sick or makes an accident, they should be served not less than 15 to 20,000 as assistance.
Hmm. Do you think, why do you think this was the recommendation of the ECC? Is there corruption at play here, Mr. Secretary?
No, I think they are just being very careful because, you know, this fund is intended for assistance to our workers, and they just want to be sure that they have enough solid funds just in case our workers get sick or meet an accident or die. So they were very careful. But I told them that they're too careful is not also very good, especially when it comes to assistance. So I was telling them that we should give a more reasonable assistance, not just 10,000, because with 10,000, I don't think a worker can be able to be compensated with that amount.
Mm. And did they say that they were open to the idea of reviewing this recommended 10,000 peso cash aid?
Well, I think they had to. It's high time that they should upgrade the assistance, because this rate has been going for the past, I think, for the past 20 years. So it's high time that we review this class assistance, a more realistic and practicable rate.
Has this distribution of the cash aid started, Mr. Secretary, and how do they claim it?
They apply for it. They can apply for it. Well, if they can just show that they are employees and that they met an accident during work, or they got sick because of work, and they will be entitled to this cash assistance.
Hmm. Now, can workers still file a claim? And again, who are eligible? The contractuals, as well as the casual and the regular, they file it with the ECC?
Yes, that's right, Ray. They just have to file it with the ECC and prove their employment status, and if they prove also of the illness or the accident that they encountered, and they will be entitled to that cash assistance.
Again, on top of hospitalization. Meanwhile, Secretary, on the 13th month pay issues, what can employees who have not received their 13th month pay do? How do they claim it?
they do not have to claim it because all the employers are aware that they are legally bound to give their workers the 13-month pay on or before December 24. And again, this 13-month pay is given to all workers regardless of status, and they have to give them this benefit on or before December 24. There is no exemption, there is no deferment, and there is no payment in kind. It should be in cash.
Now, will there be sanctions for employers, sir, who fail to give the 13th-month pay?
Well, if you are informed and we have established that the employer did not give the 13-month pay, we will give the order for the employer to pay. And if he refuses, then we can garnish the money of the employer with the bank and use it to pay the 13-month pay of the employee. And now, if they have no money in the bank, we can also go against the properties of the employer. And they were closed, sold, and then use the money to pay the 13-month pay.
But these employees, where do they file their complaint? With the DOLE straight away?
Yes, they just inform us that their employer refused or failed to give them the 13-month pay. And we will do the inspection, and if verified, we will issue the directive to the employer.
Secretary Bello, with the situation right now, already the end of the year, can you share with us the situation of unemployment in the country? The latest figures show unemployment numbers have eased, but many are still jobless. What is the agency doing about this?
That is true. There is still a lot of unemployment, but it has substantially decreased as of October this year. We went down from 10.7%, we went down to 8.5%, which shows a figure of actual employees of about 4.5 million unemployed workers. But with the improvement of our economy, especially the activation of all businesses, including the transportation, we expect that this unemployment rate will dramatically go down.
Have we started any initiatives to make sure that we can spur more employment in the coming weeks?
Yes, we have already statistics to show that there are more workers getting in, especially those in the retail business, including and most especially in the hotel and restaurant business, including transportation business. There is a lot of improvement in the hiring and employment rate of our workers.
What about the deployment of our workers overseas and the continued repatriation of our people? What kind of projects do we have ongoing there? And are we starting any other initiatives?
Actually, Rain, we have a lot of new deployment opportunities. Many countries, especially in Europe and even Asia, were asking us for our workers. We also wanted to reciprocate their demand. However, we just have to be very careful in selecting the destination. We don't want our workers to go to countries where the COVID-19 incident is very high, like, for example, in Poland, in Germany, and in England, in the United Kingdom. Maraming incident doon, kaya medyo nag-slow down tayo ng deployment doon. But nandyan yung opening. We get invitation from Canada, we get invitation from China, we get invitation from Israel, from Japan, and many other countries, including Romania and the Czech Republic. Kaya lang, kailangan ingatan natin dahil, like for example, in Poland, the ambassador of the Polish government came to me and asked for about 5,000 to 10,000 masks. And I asked him why. Sabi niya, mataas ang COVID-19 incident doon. So sabi ko, we're willing to help. Pero ako, we just want to be very sure na pagpunta nila doon, hindi sila ang magiging COVID transmitter.
Are there countries that we are opening our labor market to already? And has there been any lobbying from any of the deployment or manpower agencies to open up these markets?
I mean, the prospect is there. In fact, we already had an invitation for the signing of a bilateral agreement with Canada, with China. And in fact, if it were not for this lockdown caused by COVID-19, we would have already established a follow office or a labor office in Beijing, in Shanghai, and Shenzhen. And then also in Vancouver, in Yukon province of Canada. But, you know, because of this lockdown, we failed to sign. Because they don't want the family to sign, and we don't want to go there to sign.
Understood.
But, the prospect is there. The prospect is there, Ray.
Yes, sir. But because these bilateral agreements, you said we're on the verge of it, we haven't signed it yet, does that mean that's still on hold until further notice?
Yes, that is right, Train, because we want to be sure that if we send our OFWs in this foreign destination, we want to be sure that their rights are well protected.
So no timing yet, Secretary Bello?
Yeah, not yet. Let's observe the first quarter of next year.
Understood. Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III, always a pleasure to have you with us. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Lorraine, and Merry Christmas again.
And stay safe, sir.
Yeah.